Hey, Jillian.
Hey.
What are you doing?
Just picking up some peanut worms for lunch.
What are peanut worms?
They're a delicacy found in Vietnam and China.
What are they?
Well.
The phylum Sipuncula, commonly known as peanut worms, is comprised into two classes, Phascolosomatidia and Sipunculidia. There are six main groups within the taxon, Sipunculidae, Golfingidae, Siphonosomatidae, Antilosomatidae, Phascolosomatidae, and Aspidosiphenidae. They are bilaterally symmetrical with unsegmented bodies with the general shape of a shelled peanut. Their intestines twist in a loop and they have two digestive openings, the mouth and the anus.
Their forward body section is called the introvert, which can retract into the body by retractor muscles. The introvert contains the sipunculus mouth, and the body cavity, called the coelium, contains the fluid that transports nutrients and oxygen through their body. They have two layers of tissue and have no circulatory or respiratory system. Peanut worms move by retracting their bodies and crawling along the ocean floor. The mouth of the sipuncula is at the tip of the introvert with cilia mucus. It gathers food particles with the tentacles, and the introvert goes into the trunk where the food particles get eaten. Another way it eats is the cilia on the tentacles absorb the food particles and transfer it along the tracks to the mouth.
Most are deposit feeders and a few are filter feeders. They eat detritus, mostly from the surface or while they burrow in sand or mud. They also consume fecal material, bacteria, algae, protozoans, and small invertebrates. Fish, gastropods, cephalopods, carnivorous worms, crabs, starfish, and anemones eat them. Sipuncula are marine organisms found mainly in shallow waters in benthic habitats in tropical, temperate, and cold environments. They burrow themselves into the sand and mud or rock crevices and empty shells. They may also be found in seagrass roots within sponges and under algal mats.
But how do they reproduce?
Sipunculas are found to perform asexual and sexual reproduction, although asexual is rare. Asexual reproduction occurs by transverse fissions followed by regeneration of vital body components. In sexual reproduction, the gametes are produced in the coelemic lining and then released into the coelium where they mature. The gametes are picked up by the metafreedom system and released into the aquatic environment. The fertilization of gamete occurs outside the sipunculus when a male and female gamete meet to form a trochophore larva, which eventually develops into a mature sipuncula.
Sipuncula are protosomes, with their mouth developing first before the anus during gastrulation. They lack circulatory and respiratory systems and have coelom, a fluid that transports nutrients throughout the whole body.
The first species of the phylum Sipuncula was described in 1827 by the French zoologist Henri-Marie Ducrotte de Blainville. It started off in Pelagosphera, a metazoan larval state. It undergoes metamorphosis from its larval state to an adult state, a worm.
Sipuncula can be valuable to humans in determining the bioavailability of marine sediments. They have been used in studies to assess the amount of metals found in marine sediments. This helps environmental scientists measure the pollution and human impact on marine environments. Sipunculas are also valuable for reproductive biology and are emerging as important non-model organisms for evolutionary and developmental biology.
What other organisms are they similar to?
The diversity within the Sipuncula family is believed to have existed since the Mesozoic era. The structure of the Sipuncula phylogenetic tree has been consistent in many studies. However, there is uncertainty in the relation Sipuncula has with Antilosomatidae, Phascolosomatidae, Aspidosiphenidae, and Golfingidae. Molecular hypotheses have been made with evidence supporting that the Sipunculans were one of the first diverging groups from the annelid lineage.
Based on the journal published Phylogenetic Tree, Sipuncula was the outgroup and Phascolosomatidae and Antilosomatidae are sister taxa. Siphonosomatidae is the sister group of the clade with Aspidosiphenidae, Phascolosomatidae, and Antilosomatidae. Those four species form the clade Golfingidae. These trees suggest that Sipuncula are closely related to either Annelida or Arthropoda. On the data matrix tree, Sipuncula was the sister taxa of Annelida, since they share similar morphological properties. However, based on the 16S tree, it suggests that Sipuncula may not be as closely related to Annelida, since the sister taxa of Sipuncula on this tree is Arthropoda. These trees show uncertainty as one shows them more closely related to Annelida, while the other tree shows it's more closely related to Arthropoda. A possible explanation for this uncertainty is that Annelida are segmented and have a circulatory system, but Cypuncula lacks segmentation and a circulatory system.
You guys want to try some?
No.
Yeah, I'd rather not.
More for me.